everybody. It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. Today we're going to be installing our butterfly garden, finally. But I had to take a little breather after putting the last 7 bricks of 36 stepping stones in. It's been a long haul. It was very hard putting in the ones we did yesterday because it was so hot. Yes, hot in Wisconsin. It almost was 80. Today it's in the low 60s, so it was much better working. They went in much faster. We are not as tired out, especially after doing all that mulch the week before. So after my little break, we'll break out the milkweed seeds and all of the butterfly mixes that we bought, and we're going to get them planted so they can start growing for the butterflies when they get here. It's very windy out today, so we decided in order for anybody to be able to hear us, we should start indoors. We got a little carried away this year with our seeds. Yes, you can get carried away, but we're going to do the best we can in the short window of opportunity that we have, that's called spring, with our daughter getting married at the end of the month and all sorts of things to do. So we have our vegetables, some of the vegetables we're going to be trying this year.
So you've got beets, you've got peppers, you've got kale, cucumber, basil, a lot of different carrots, radishes, asparagus, and what is this? Oh, eggplant, and you've got bok choy, radishes, zucchini. And this isn't the plants, these are just the seeds.
No, these are the seeds, right. And then we got very carried away on our flowers. We were given a lot of these seeds when we did some volunteer work, so that was fun, but you know how it goes. When you start looking at catalogs, you start seeing things that are unique that you haven't tried in your garden yet and would like to try. These are all different kinds of strawberries. Climbing, pink, orange, giant, blue crystal, black, white, and yellow crystal.
And then you have one magic one over there, the mystery one.
Well, that's a giant one.
Oh, that's a giant one.
See how tiny those seeds are?
It's amazing. I can barely see them. I thought that was an empty package.
No, that's in there. And then we got coreopsis. We just have a variety. Then Rick wanted giant sunflowers, so we sent to both of us sent away to different places for those. I wanted some egg gourds, so I have enough now for the rest of my life, I think. We've got delicata squash, the zeppelin that we like so much, and just a variety of different flowers. Then at the dollar store, earlier in the season, they were selling these boxes of flowers, seeds, for a dollar. 12% of them is the seed, and the rest is filler and starting mix that'll keep them moist and give them a little something to grab a hold of.
Well, these are just the hummingbird mix and the butterfly, the wildflower blends.
Right. And then they also had the zinnia and the marigolds, which we're not going to be putting there. Then we've got the end cap varieties that we tried last year that we really found great with our zinnias. They had the wildflower butterfly and hummingbird mix and the wildflower aromatic mix. How can you not want to do those? Our house should be full of flowers by the end of summer, hopefully. And if not, we'll blame the weather.
Well, this doesn't even include all the bulbs you have, and of course the zinnias that you dearly love, and of course Tim's package of zinnias.
Right, and then our gardening friend Bob gave us some tuberous begonias that he started from his, which are, they're growing great. We've got the yellow raspberry, the fall blooming ones out there, and some blueberries, a couple of grape varieties, and this is not even our trip to the garden store to buy our tomatoes and our peppers and our other stuff.
So you think we're going to be a little bit busy today?
We are. We definitely are. It's just the first week of May, but I think with global warming or what's been going on lately, I think we're going to be okay to start at least the flower part.
Well, we're going to start with this group, and we're going to generously scatter them along with some of those as well from NCAP, which we like. Plus, you also bought NCAP the Zinnia mix too this year,
yes,
right?
Yes, I did.
I think you got a couple of those.
Yes. Plus, we have the butterfly milkweed that the butterflies love. Now, I'm hoping that some of that is in here also, but we know for sure this orange butterfly weed, it's called, grows great here. And then this is the swamp milkweed that we purchased.
And we're going to be going to some of the plant sales and picking up some actual
plugs.
Different
they have different plugs
butterfly.
With the different varieties of milkweed that grow in our area. I think there's five that grow pretty well in our area. So we'll be going to get some of those plugs and see how those work.
Well,
we need to get plant in here.
Let's take our two big buckets out, start with that, and maybe grab a couple of bags of the end cap, and we'll do our Johnny Appleseed act. Can we dance while we do it?
Sure. We're going to have to sprinkle them, too, remember, to hold them down to the soil so they don't blow away in this wind.
Kind of like dancing with the stars in the garden.
All right. Oh, and today, just in case anyone wants to know, today is National Nude Gardening Day. But don't even think about it. It's not going to happen.
Thank you. I do not intend to go outside without clothes on. I don't care what they say. These seeds will be protected from viewing anything they shouldn't be seeing. They're too young. These are minors. Keep that in mind.
We're going to put the wild butterfly mix toward the front, and then we're going to put the aromatic mix closer to the fence, where we will be closer to it for smelling purposes. This is what this mix looks like. And each package is enough for 200 square feet. So 200 square feet is 20 by 10. There'd be plenty here.
Well, you have to realize that some of this is fillers and crystals and other things too, so it's not just seed.
Correct. And we want it dense. So that's fine that it's going to be very, very populated. Plant you.
Okay. Neighbors have accused you of doing that.
Since this is everything.
Notice how she ignores
mixed
that.
Mixed together, they suggested that you just lightly step on it to work it into the soil. It doesn't need to be covered because it has the right things in the mix. So we could do a little dance out here before we sprinkle it. Now, we do have other things coming up, like this is rose mallow that comes up every year. We've got some lilies and some lungwort and different things that will also be here. Ah, the aromatic.
Feel like Johnny Appleseed?
I do. Now we have just a few of the orange milkweed seeds. So I'm just sprinkling them along the edge.
You could be on Dancing with the Stars. Dancing with the Gardener Stars.
Behind me, we usually have common milkweed growing by itself, but we also purchased some swamp milkweed, so I'm going to sprinkle that in here also. And I'm just going to push these in a little bit. Now comes the fun part, actually watering them in. And we're using this very special wholesale nozzle that the nurseries use from the Dram Corporation. This is especially made for newly planted seeds and seedlings. So it doesn't disturb it. It's just a very fine mist.
And it's important to keep it moist
until the seeds germinate and you see them sprouting up. And even then, you don't want them ever to dry out until they're actually formed their second leaves.
Sure is windy out today.
Yes, it is. Nice working outside, though. We got a lot done today. I'm glad that most of the major things are done now as far as the walkway goes. But we got our butterfly garden planted and watered, and now it's just a matter of keeping it watered so that it'll germinate and grow, and it's up to Mother Nature then to make sure everything comes up. It ought to be beautiful when it's done. We still have a whole table full of things that need to be planted seed-wise, but that's for another day. We're being treated for dinner tonight by our son and daughter-in-law, so we have to go and get ready for that. And it's a beautiful way to end a beautiful day. Lots done. Happy to have it done, too.
Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day to everyone. And if you enjoyed this video and you'd like to support our garden blog, please give us a thumbs up. We'd like to hear what's happening in your yard. And if you'd like to be part of our garden family, please subscribe. Love to have you.
Well, should I order 50 cubic yards of mulch?
No.
You don't want any more?
No. I think it's you head to the shower time.
Really?
Uh-huh. You got the grass cut. It looks beautiful.
Yep. Well, a lot of work, but I think it paid off. So, you want me to hit the showers first?
Sayonara.
Okay.
Connect with us on YouTube.